Hello, and welcome back to another Let's Play Dwarf Fortress, where the dwarves are dwarfy. I already said that one. But this time, they're extra dwarfy. And we are still working on another secret project. And these guys are stabbing each other in the face. Crimson Demon and Nog. They're doing a good job, too. And Nixitter is watching. Ooh, Superfly White Dwarf Jeweler has created a Sasked. A smoky quartz window. Oh, yes! Window. Wait. Migrants. Hang on, migrants. Window. Show me my window! Asked. Asked. It's only worth $8,400, but it's all craft worship is of the highest quality. It's a smoky quartz window that menaces with spikes of smoky quartz. Sweet. Alright, and we got migrants. Yay? Who are you? Kumil. Teked. Oh wow, I'm glad that flock of elephants that usually hangs out on the edge there isn't there. Arendorable has given birth to a baby boy on top of the motherfucking Gravitron. While Z-Sword... Yes, you have a fucking sword. Somewhere. There. You are using a copper short sword with bands of superior quality gorilla bone. And it's got a three-pointed star and mule bone. You are a member of the Masons. Seeker baby. Oh, he's got two babies now. Shorast and Zuglar. They're adorable. You're just a baby machine. Yes. Four children. Ghostetler, Jail Roof, Imchim, Shaft Furnace, Shorast, Cloister Carries, and Zuglar, Author Ringed. She worships Anriz Beanford, the Seas of Fur. What a weird-ass fucking multiple procreating dwarf. My goodness. Alright, well, I'm gonna go through and wait for these... Why are you not going somewhere, Teked? You're blocking all the other migrants. Oh, I don't know. He'll eventually get in. Teked? There's a meeting area. There's a lot of them. Come to one of them. Look, there's one here. Active. Oh, well. Carrying on. This was a rather large migration. I thought it was done, and then it just kept going. There's a lot. We had 125 before, and we're up to 141 right now. And they're still coming. Eurist, Milker, Eurist Lancerbook, Regoth Fenced Open, Clasp Polished. Too many. Okay, looks like it's done. 141. Well, I predict a military engagement for most of these people. Because we are shortly going to be doing something that's going to require a lot of idle time anyway. Hey, look, elephants. So, I'm thinking that a lot of these are going to be military dwarves. So if you get named after a military dwarf and die in a sparring accident, I'll do the initial strangulation process. Weed out the ones with weak throats. And then I'll name them all. Okay? Alright. Okay, Rednux just had another baby, and Rednux also beats Inthernal for the number of babies. Rednux actually has six children. Hexcrack, Bustward, Coronel Neil, Hameboard, Sinful Grizzly Mansions, the White Dwarf, Galley Climate, Edsel Staffwealth, and Domus Relic Revered. She's a dubious worshipper of the same... The Seas of Fur must be the goddess or god of fertility and beans or something. Why is there a dog in the arena? What are you doing, dog? Dog. Channel muscles. Why is that dog not put in a cage? Sibrek channel muscles. I don't understand. Cage. They're all caged. Everything is caged. Maybe I can't cage that dog. I must have to slaughter it. Well, doggy. It's waiting to be trained. Slaughter. Their owners must have died in the arena. Ah, goody. Okay, well, either I've done something wrong with this windmill. I made it as a test. I put it on a gear. Either I've done something wrong with it, or there's no wind on this map. Which is bad. I think I've probably done something wrong. I've got a channeled tile in the center going down to this gear. But the gear doesn't go anywhere. Maybe it needs to power something. I don't know. I thought that all you needed to do was put it on a gear and it would tell you how much wind you had on the map and how much power you could generate from it. But I guess not. Oh yeah, we're all walled in now. The only way into our fortress is here. Over this bridge, which flings that way, which I am about to put on a pressure plate. Which I will put here. So they will walk like this, and then flingy, and some of them will fling, and some of them will be atom smashed. And actually, I think I might put it here. Yeah, this looks like a better place, because I want them to be like here-ish, and then fling, atom smashed. And then that leads the only way from there is up the Gravitron. So, good stuff. I knew it was coming, you knew it was coming, it was time. And the vile force of darkness has arisen. Everybody get inside. Everybody, even soldiers. Everybody inside right this very second right now. Oh my god, they arrived right at my bridge trap. Wow, I hope they get flung. Well, that's a great way to test it, so first thing I want to do is get everybody inside and lock that up. Everything else is locked up and inaccessible. There's only two ways in and out. This is a way in. You need to be going inside right now. Over the Gravitron. Over the Gravitron you go. Why are you standing there? Stop standing there. There you go. Oh, they killed my puppy. Oh, they can't get that way. There's a tree in the way. Shit. Oh, damn it. Well, someday we'll chop that tree down. I didn't plan for that. Looks like they can get up this way. And if they do that, then they're gonna have to go all the way around here. All the way down here. All the way over here. All the way down here, and then back there. Let's see how resilient these goblins are, and how determined they are to mess with us. Okay, there's some elephants in the way for them to play with. Lots of traps. But for now, we need to get everybody inside. Okay. Is there any dwarves down here that I'm waiting for? I think we're pretty well good. Yes, 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 forbidden, I know. Once I get, Alright, looks like everybody's in here, so I can lock the outer gates there. So, if I remember how to do that, it should be this lever here. Pull. Thank you, Gerathor, or whoever you are. Oh, nope, that was the wrong one, but same function. Now, whoops. Okay, let me just take a quick peek, make sure there's no dwarves outside the walls. Just the humans. Okay, so now, I can let my soldiers go outdoors. That way people will shut up. Whoa, we've been invaded by bonobos. Uh-oh. Shields, I can do that. Alright, so we'll make some shields and then see how the siege goes. Dang, I was hoping for that trap. Oh well. Iron shields times two, yeah. Okay, carrying on. Oh, duh. They're trapped in between both of these trees. Brilliant. Absolutely brilliant. Way to go, goblins. So unless there is another vile force of darkness somewhere, I don't think there is, then we are invincible because we've been saved by trees! No wonder the elves survived so long. They had invincible trees. Alright, well, everybody is allowed to go outside now. I've blocked off the Gravitron because there's no point. And so this one's blocked off, the Gravitron's blocked off, so now they can all go out in this area here and walk around in the walkways and do their normal dwarfy things and go about their dwarfy business. Yeah, like J-Ray managed to get to his bed there. He's unconscious in it. And his horse is on his table. What the fuck, Channel Gate? So yeah, I think that we're gonna go ahead and chalk this one up to, Goblins 0, Rubber Tree 1. Go Rubber Trees! So next time on Let's Play Dwarf Fortress Adventure Mode, this is not Adventure Mode, Fortress Mode, we're gonna chop down these trees once they're gone, probably build an extra walkway here. I know it's not wise to help the goblins, but it is if you have things that you want them to die on, like two bridge traps attached to levers. So, until then,